But you can just listen to it and do nothing. I can't.
Captain, that is what they're waiting for. They're waiting for us to attempt a rescue.
I can't just let him stay there.
Perhaps we can rescue him, Mr. Spock. Now, I suggest that we do whatever they want.
Do what they want, sir?
Not the way they want it, however. We must first convince them that they have provoked us to recklessness. James, I do not mean to presume upon your authority. What I propose is that I circle around to their rear while you two provide a frontal assault. It should be sufficiently violent to cover whatever I do.
What will you do?
Why, slip into their camp and free him.
No.
James. Remember, I was something of a backwoodsman. I doubt that you could do what I was bred to.
I can't let you risk it, Mr. President.
Well, I am no longer president. Mr. Spock, any comment?
Help me, Spock!
No, sir.
One matter further, gentlemen. We fight on their level with trickery, brutality, finality. We match their evil. I know, James. I was reputed to be a gentleman when I was commander-in-chief. During the four bloodiest years of my country's history, I gave orders that sent 100,000 men to their death at the hands of their brothers. There's no honorable way to kill. No gentle way to destroy. There's nothing good in war except its ending. And you are fighting for the lives of your crew.
Your campaign, Mr. President.